The original iPod was one of Apple's most successful products of all time, and Apple was able to build off this monumental success with the iPod Shuffle, iPod Nano, and of course, the iPod Touch. In the early 2010s, iPod Touches were extremely popular, as they were essentially iPhones that couldn't make phone calls or use cellular data, but they were less than a third of the price. Despite this though, over the past several years, iPod Touches have basically disappeared off the face of the planet. So, what happened to the iPod Touch? Well, taking a look back at the history of the iPod, the original iPod came out way back in October of 2001. It was advertised as a device that allowed you to hold thousands of songs in your pocket, and likewise, it came along with a pretty hefty starting price of $400. This was followed up by a slew of upgraded versions year after year. But, for the most part, the differences between these versions were just increased capacity and lower prices. The next major upgrade to the iPod lineup would come out in 2004 with the iPod Mini. The iPod Mini boasted the same capacity as many of the classic iPod models, but it was quite a bit cheaper, starting at $250. Soon after though, Apple would come out with the iPod Nano, which was essentially a futuristic replacement to the iPod Mini. The iPod Nano would have a smaller starting storage capacities, but it also came along with even lower starting prices, starting at $150. Around the same time, we would also see the launch of the iPod Shuffle in 2005. The iPod Shuffle ditched the screens that were iconic to the iPods up until then. However, they offered an extremely small form factor and an even lower starting price of $100. Moving on, we finally saw the release of the iPod Touch in late 2007, starting at $300. This would quickly be followed up with the second, third, fourth, and fifth generation, basically year after year. But the fifth generation is where we would start to see a shift in the trend. The fifth generation iPod came out in October of 2012, and we wouldn't see the next generation for another 3 more years. The iPod sixth generation launch would be extremely low-key. Apple didn't do a keynote or really anything to hype up the launch. One day, the new iPod would just be available for purchase on their website. More surprisingly, Apple would take out the iPod tab on the Apple website just 1 month before the launch of the iPod 6G, making it even more inconspicuous. Aside from a very low-key launch, the upgrade itself was also very low-key. The iPod 6G was basically identical to the iPod 5G, except for the small loop attachment point that was on the iPod 5G, but not the 6. There were a couple of minor internal upgrades, but even those were not that big of a deal. This decision from Apple was one of the first signs that Apple didn't see a very bright future for the iPod. As you guys know, Apple is very intentional about creating physical distinctions between each generation of their devices. This way, people can easily tell when someone has the latest Apple device. For instance, with the iPhone 12, we saw a return to flat edges from curved edges. But evidently, Apple didn't choose this route for the iPod 6G. 4 years after the iPod 6G, Apple would actually come out with the iPod 7G in May of 2019. However, no one really knows that this even happened. Again, this generational upgrade was visually undetectable, and the majority of the changes were minor internal upgrades. If you go under the music tab on the Apple website, you can actually still find this iPod Touch starting at $200. So, the iPod Touch isn't completely dead just yet, but no one is really buying it today for a variety of reasons, starting with the popularity of iPhones. The iPod started off as a music-centered device, designed for simply listening to music and podcasts. However, by the time the iPod Touch came out, the iPod had transitioned into more of a media device. People were buying iPods to take advantage of iMessage and FaceTime and play mobile games. As a result, iPod Touches were the perfect device for kids. They could play games and keep in touch with their friends at home, and they could take it out with them and listen to music on the go. As for adults, iPods turned into the perfect secondary device. For instance, one might have a BlackBerry or flip phones for SMS and phone calls, and they might have an iPod Touch for the gym or working out. This allowed many people to enjoy nearly all the perks of having an iPhone without having to shell out $650 or even more. Over the past several years though, the vast majority of people have gone ahead and just bought a smartphone. Cell phone service companies like AT&T, T-Mobile, and Verizon have gotten more competitive than ever before. And even Apple themselves have started offering 0% interest financing options for all of their products if you get an Apple Card. As a result, you can quite easily get a flagship smartphone for $0 down. Moreover, Apple has become much more price sensitive recently, launching many more budget phones and keeping around older models for much longer. For instance, the new iPhone SE starts at just $400. Evidently, smartphones have become much more accessible financially, and this, combined with the greater social need for smartphones, has led smartphone adoption rates to go through the roof. In 2010 and 2011, only about 20-30% of the US population owned a smartphone. By 2018 though, roughly 70% of the US population owned a smartphone. Considering that about a quarter of the US is under the age of 18, virtually all adults and a significant portion of kids in the US have a smartphone today, thus eliminating the need for an iPod. Aside from increased smartphone ownership, we have also seen an influx of different media devices. Tablets are cheaper than ever before, and it's not that difficult to pick up a decent tablet for less than $200. You can even get a brand new iPad for as low as $400. Given that most people looking to buy an iPod today are simply looking for a media device, it makes little sense to choose an iPod over a tablet or iPad unless portability is an extremely important factor. Something else to consider is that over the past several years, streaming music has become very popular. Many people have completely turned to services like Spotify and Apple Music to fulfill their musical desires. So, not very many people still prefer to buy and download songs. Thus, most people don't really need a dedicated device just to store music. As for using an iPod with streaming services, you can download songs to listen to them offline when you go out. However, one of the biggest perks of using such services is being able to listen to basically any song whenever you want. As we all know though, that requires an internet connection, which makes the iPod not that useful when streaming music outside of your house. On top of all of these social trends, Apple has also consciously been working on making the iPod Touch obsolete. If you haven't noticed, the iPod hasn't been updated with any of the new features that have come out recently. The iPod Touch hasn't received Face ID, edge-to-edge displays, or the latest processors. In fact, the iPod never even received Touch ID, Apple Pay, waterproof technology, or even better battery life. The latest iPod Touch only has a battery capacity of 1,043 mAh. To put that in perspective, the iPhone 12 has a battery capacity of about 2,850 mAh, or nearly 3 times as much. Moreover, as we previously discussed, Apple took out the iPod tab from their homepage. And we also haven't seen very many iPod commercials, if any, from Apple recently. In fact, if you go onto the official Apple YouTube channel and look up iPod, you won't find a single video that's actually about the iPod. Clearly, Apple is avoiding driving customers to the iPod. But why? Well, first of all, iPods are one of the cheapest devices that Apple sells. So, they likely also have the lowest profit margins. As a result, adding the newest features and processors into the iPod Touch is one of their last priorities. Something else to consider is that iPods are often bought by parents for their kids instead of a smartphone. And Apple would of course prefer that these parents bought iPhones for their kids as opposed to iPods. That logic is most applicable to parents and their kids, but the same reasoning applies to any potential buyer of the iPod. They'd rather you buy an iPad or iPhone, so they make those pages much more accessible. However, if you're one of those stubborn people who are only willing to buy the iPod and nothing more, they still offer that option, but you do have to do a bit of digging to find it. At the end of the day, the iPod was essential in turning Apple around after a rather rough 1990s. Apple cleverly built upon the success of the original iPod by launching a variety of different iPods at multiple price points. Once the iPhone came out though, the iPod Touch essentially became a cheaper alternative to the iPhone that hindered people from making the jump to the iPhone. At first, this wasn't that big of a deal, as Apple had plenty of demand for all of their iDevices. However, once demand for the iPhone started slowing down in the mid-2010s, Apple turned their focus to driving iPod customers to the iPhone. Apple went ahead and basically halted iPod development, considering that the design nor features have really changed in a full decade. On top of this, they decided to completely stop promoting the iPod and have even made it harder to find. At the same time, people have become more open to spending larger amounts of money on phones, and many have grown to prefer music streaming services. Thus, this has only made it easier for Apple to ditch the iPod Touch and transition their customers over to the iPhone and iPad. And that's how and why Apple ditched the iPod Touch. Did you guys have an iPod Touch growing up? Comment that down below. Also, drop a like if you guys thought this video explained the downfall of the iPod Touch well. And of course, consider joining our Discord community to suggest future video ideas, and consider subscribing to see more questions logically answered. But until then, I'm Hari, and I'll see you guys on the next one.